let's move now to another thing, the paragraph spacing. Let's create another paragraph. And I put the paragraph just below the first one. You see, I have not put any empty line in between those two paragraphs. Let's put some color to this paragraph so you can we can distinguish one by other. So if I select now this paragraph, I can increase. Oh, let's make another one because we might need it. Let's remove the color formatting. So I select the middle paragraph, and if I increase the paragraph spacing, you see that the space above and below the paragraph increases. And you see that there are no empty lines. I cannot click in that in this area between the paragraphs. So I define my spacing between each paragraph. And I can decrease and increase the spacing of the paragraph. And if you can see here on the sidebar of the paragraph properties window, you see whenever I increase, is the value here. So I can increase the spacing independently, only above. And for example, I can decrease the below spacing. So let's leave it like the same value, both of them. Now let's move to the indent buttons. If I select the paragraph, I can increase the indent distance. You can see it increases the distance between the left side of the document. Or I can as well decrease the distance. And you can see here, I can do the same here in this button over here. I can increase or decrease the indentation distance from the left. Let's put it back together. Let's make it zero again. Okay, you see that if I let's, for example, increase the indent. You see that this slider over here, you see that those two little triangles, they go around the indentation. So another way to change the indentation is to drag this little triangle over here, drag it left. All right. And if I want to decrease the indentation from the right side, there is no button to do that. I can do this from this little triangle over here. You see, I decrease or increase the indentation. Okay, let's put it back together. Oh, sorry. And then I have this little triangle over here. If I change this, let's make it over here, you see this triangle increases the indent of the first line. So I can have some, because usually when we write paragraphs in a book, it's very common to have the first line have some space more than the other lines. You see that this one controls the right indent. This controls the first line indent. And this one controls the whole left indent. So I can move them and change them. And of course, I can control the first line indent from the button here. First line indent. Can control the right indent from here and the left indent from here. Okay, let's make them again the default values. Oh, another thing, if you make a first line indent, you can swap it to be with the button here to be the in the hanging indent, be the opposite, as you can see, hanging and normal. So you can easily align your indents using these triangles over here or using the buttons here. And of course you can align multiple paragraphs together if you select all of them. And let's make them now to be, sorry. Again, I will select all my paragraphs and let's make the left indent here, the after text indent, let's make it 0, and the before text indent, let's make it 0, and let's make 0 the first line indent, or I can change from this slider here to make it to make all paragraphs be the same. And let's make the above and below spacing the same. Let's increase the paragraph spacing from here. Some of you might say, hey, this looks very complex and tedious. And if I have to do this for every of my paragraph, I will spend a lot of time. The answer is that first of all, you don't usually need to apply all these formattings. You just sometimes you just need the alignment and maybe the first line indent, maybe some line spacing. But most importantly, you will learn next lessons that you learn how to define a default style for all your paragraph, so that you don't have to edit all the paragraphs one by one. So that's it for basic paragraph formatting. In the next video, we'll have some more additional options.